One of the best techniques for measuring microstructure is electron backscatter diffraction, more commonly known by the acronym EBSD. EBSD is a technique that we can use in the scanning electron microscope, the SEM. Here is an SEM with an electron column and the sample shown in black. The sample needs to be flat and polished for EBSD, and we tilt it up to a high angle from the horizontal, typically 70 degrees. So here in the sketch, we can label the different major parts of the SEM. But what is most relevant here is what happens when the electron beam, shown in green, interacts with the sample. Remember, we are looking at a crystalline material here, and if it is polycrystalline, it is made up of grains with different crystal orientations, as indicated by the grey lines. So when the electron beam strikes a sample, we get scattering of those electrons. There may be a little energy loss, but it is close to an elastic event. Where those scattered electrons satisfy the conditions for Bragg diffraction, or n lambda equals 2d sine theta, we get diffracted electrons in the form of a pair of open cones for each lattice plane. And if we insert a detector close to the sample, we can image those diffracted electrons, and they impinge on the detector to form pairs of lines, or Kikuchi lines, and the bands are called Kikuchi bands. As there are multiple lattice planes in the crystal lattice, there are in turn multiple Kikuchi bands, and these form the diffraction pattern, which is known as an EBSP, or an electron backscatter diffraction pattern. If we go back to the SEM, we can insert a detector from the side of the chamber to image these electrons. The electrons are typically imaged using a scintillator, such as a phosphor screen, and that image is taken to a computer to be processed. Now, if we know enough about the sample, such as the possible phases, the computer can index those diffraction patterns and confirm the phase and give us the crystallographic orientation. It can do this with very good specifications. The spatial resolution is on the order of tens to a few hundreds of nanometers. The precision with which we can measure the orientation is typically a fraction of a degree, and the speed with the latest CMOS-based EBSD detectors can be up to 5,000 index diffraction patterns per second. In addition, we can couple this with another technique on the SEM, energy dispersive X-ray spectrometry, or EDS. Now, EDS gives us information about the composition, so we can combine the crystallographic information from EBSD with the chemical or compositional information from EDS. This combination makes EBSD with EDS the perfect technique for automated microstructural characterization.